Hello and welcome. Did you know that Redis now supports vector storage, allowing you to store your embeddings as vectors? New to all this machine learning and AI stuff? No worries. Let's go over the basics and discover the tools we have to get our vectors working for us and producing some amazing search results. Vectors are coordinates in a high-dimensional space. For ease of understanding, we'll just use two dimensions until we get our tesseract back from repair. In the context of vector databases, each vector serves as a numerical representation of features, characteristics, or embeddings associated with an object. This object can be diverse, ranging from a document, an image, a sound file, a video file, even a user profile. The uniqueness of vector databases lies in their ability to efficiently manage and process such vectorized data, allowing for nuanced and high-dimensional representations of information. The concept behind vector databases is based on the fact that many real-world datasets can be easily represented as vectors. By adopting this approach, databases can capture relationships and similarities between objects. For instance, a vector representing the features of a PDF document might include information about the frequency of certain words or the presence of specific patterns. Similarly, an image vector could encapsulate details about color distribution, shapes, sharp corners, soft arcs, and textures. This vectorized representation enables advanced analytics, machine learning, and similarity search operations, making vector databases crucial in applications where understanding the complex relationships within data is essential. Semantic search, which involves understanding the meaning and context behind user queries, is yet another area where vector databases play a pivotal role. Traditional search methods may struggle with the nuances of language and context, but vector databases, by representing words or phrases as vectors, can capture semantic relationships. This enhances the precision of search results, delivering more contextually relevant information to users. The ability of vector databases to efficiently manage and analyze high-dimensional data makes them important in advanced data-driven applications, enabling them to produce contextually accurate responses from unstructured data. When a user enters a query, the semantic search engine transforms their query into a vector representation. By using vector similarity algorithms, such as cosine similarity, the engine can mathematically identify documents or items with similar semantic meaning to the user's query. This goes beyond keyword matching, allowing the engine to discern the context and meaning behind the words used in the query. As a result, the search results are more accurate and contextually relevant, presenting users with documents that not only contain the queried keywords, but also share similar semantic content. This application of vector databases in semantic search illustrates their ability to elevate search functionality in information-rich environments, providing users with a more intuitive and insightful search experience. With the lens of Redis as the vector database, let's see how we would go about converting text to an embedding. Imagine that we're maintaining a repository of JSON objects based on books in a library. Each object has a descriptive paragraph about an individual book. We'll use that text field to create a unique embedding to store inside the particular JSON object. I'll be using Hugging Face's Sentence Transformers, a Python framework for embedding sentences, text, and images. I'll use a specific model called AllMiniLML6V2. This model comes to me pre-trained for semantic search, so I can start searching for similar descriptions immediately. Just for interest's sake, let's check out what an embedding looks like. This is the array of numbers that was generated from the description text. Impressive! We now have an embedding for one of our book's description text fields. I'll create embeddings for all of our 15,000 book objects to really harness the power of semantic search over our library. Now we'll want to create a vector index to quickly parse through all of our vectors. I'll use the Redis client library, Redis VL, to create a schema and index the JSON objects. Notice that the schema object, named book_index, dictates what key prefixes to watch, what query fields it will be indexing, and the specific data types of those fields. Now let's create a query object to compare against our existing embeddings. First, we'll convert a string of text we are searching for into an embedding. Let's make a bold request for a book where dinosaurs survived the meteor crash and still rule the world. I'll convert this text into an embedding using the same method as with the original description text for our JSON book objects. Now I'll insert the embedding query into the vector query object you see here. Note that it is listing what embeddings to search through, what fields to include, and how many results to return. Now when I execute this query in Redis VL, I'll receive the results with my requested fields, the correct number of results, and the vector distance for each result. The smaller the vector distance value, the closer the result is to the original vector query embedding. Let's try adding a traditional search filter to our search. Let's say I only want to receive results that contain the tag science fiction. I'll add this filter expression property with a simple filter where the genres array has to contain the term science fiction. Now we only receive the semantic search results with the genre science fiction. That's neat. There is a vast and expanding world of possibilities with vector embeddings, semantic search, and integrating Redis into your applications. You'll be amazed at how many ways you can integrate Redis as a vector database into your current code base. If you'd like to learn more, check out redis.com for all kinds of real-world use cases and their solutions using modern data structures. Also check out Redis University, your one-stop shop for learning all things Redis. Make sure to check out the Redis as a vector database course to learn the ins and outs not covered in this video. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe to receive notifications on new videos, live streams, and tutorials. You wouldn't want to miss out on our upward vector.